Just before I leave the stage, you probably all can tell from the crowd that this is an amazing network of people here. The computer's not made that can download Danny's brain. It's also not made that can do the matrix that has all the connections between all the people in this room. And the thing that drew me to the folk music scene, where I've been happily making my living for the last 25 years, is that because it removes that barrier between performers and audience. Everyone is connected potentially by the culture of it all. So I'd like to thank all the people in the room who have ever taken part in organising a festival or a music camp or an event. I've seen people here from Port Fairy, Malden, Brunswick, music camps, all sorts of community music networks. So hats off to all of you as well.
And thank you very much, Andy Rigby, his wonderful harp, that wonderful tune for Gail Shannon. Thanks also to Derek Gill, who's had to run away, as he mentioned. We've got a few more artists to go, so and it's seeming like it's a little bit cooler now. Next up on stage, two musicians that have been part of the Australian folk music scene for many, many years, singing traditional English songs and Australian traditional songs. They've made the trip here to Dalesford from the Blue Mountains. Please welcome Margaret and Bob Fagan.
The olive and wine, now This is how the end of our world will be. Digging the dust of our legacy. Praying for rain to wash away footprints and memories. A purified skies on dry hills, blowing me.
Come, darkness, come, Lord.
Next up on stage, Tony O'Rourke, very fine Australian guitarist, banjo player, specialises in playing bluegrass and Irish music, and he's been playing around the country and overseas with many fine musicians for a long time. He's brought some extra musicians with him, so it's going to be a great fun set. Please welcome Tony O'Rourke.
Thanks very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I never ever thought in my life I'd ever be asked to do a command performance. My Irish Republican sentiments. First time I ever met Danny was at Tarramurra, and I've seen a side of Danny down the years that many of you perhaps wouldn't be aware of. I was singing with a man who became a very good friend of mine, a chap called Bob Jones, who was at one stage a member of the Bluegrass Boys. And Bob was a wonderful singer of all the parts, the lead, the tenor, the baritone, and a great teacher. I learned a lot of my singing skills, whatever they are, off Bob. And I knew that Bob was, he just loved songs. He sang bluegrass, but he loved songs from anywhere. And it was about midnight, and this rather, I was going to say larger, an obvious figure, came walking over the hill, and at that stage we had met Danny very briefly, and I happened to mention to Bob, I said, oh, this fellow, I said, he's got more songs than you and me put together. I said, he's sort of sea shanties, Irish songs, songs from the British Isles. And he came over and I'll have to excuse my London accent, he said, oh, what have we got here, lads? A bit of bluegrass. And we must have sat there until 3 or 4 in the morning singing bluegrass songs. And if you didn't know who Danny Spooner was and you just happened upon him that night, you would have thought that he was a straight up the line bluegrass singer. Anyway,
Yes.
Yes.
You
I know some of you probably wouldn't necessarily be of a religious persuasion, but we're going to sing one of, certainly I know it's one of Danny's favourite songs, and it's one of my favourite songs. It's a song that I guess personally reflected my situation when I was a young boy. It's a song that we learned from the Stanley Brothers in Virginia. It's called Mother Left Me Her Life.
Oh,
Tony O'Rourke and his special band Dancing with Angels. Fantastic music. It's been a great afternoon. We've got two more artists on stage. Now, just actually, before I forget, at the end of the concert, we need a few people to help out just to stack chairs. They need to be stacked in groups of six, the fabric chairs separate from the other chairs. So if a few people could stay back just at the end of the concert, it would be most appreciated. And also, if a few people wouldn't mind washing cups and saucers out the back in the kitchen, that would be a great help because the hall is beautifully clean. And I'd like to thank the Shire, the Goldville Shire, for giving us the Dalesford Town Hall for this wonderful afternoon. Okay. Two very fine musicians have travelled from Adelaide to be with us this afternoon. Please welcome Pete Titchener and Eric Vogel.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to be here. Honour and privilege has been a word used many times this afternoon, Dan. A landmine. Sincere, of course. Dan is probably, he's partly responsible for me becoming a songwriting superstar. When I first came from Scotland to Australia in 1969, I arrived with nothing but good looks and awesome talent and palpable sexual charisma. And poor eyesight, yeah, but the future was still uncertain. When I left Scotland, I was very much involved with Scottish traditional music. That's what I did most. I sang Scottish traditional songs. I had my own group called the Tweets, Eric and the Tweets. And when I arrived in Australia, I thought I was going to be Scotland's foremost exponent of Scottish traditional songs. And I went to Canada, first port call in Australia. And it took me a while to find the Canberra folk scene, because it was well hidden. Just like Martin Turnbull's bombs. I swore I wouldn't bring politics into it. I eventually found it, and Bob Rummery was my first bloke I met, folks in one of the best blokes you can leave. And at the Kingston Folk Club the following week, Dan Spooner was the guest artist. Dan was a big favourite in the Canberra folk scene. And he sang these Scottish traditional songs I've never heard. And I thought, well, that's my career as a Scottish traditional folk singer. I better start writing my own songs. And that's honestly a true story. I realised that the competition was too fierce in that field, so I found this is the first song Dan, to my great pleasure, has recorded a couple of my songs over the years, and I think this is the first song of mine he ever recorded. I'll sing it for you. I mean, every song we've sang today has been for you. But I'll just make that point again. For nearly 60 years, I've been a cottie of droughts and fires and floods. I've been through plenty. This country's dust and mud. I've seen my tears.